Hey, do you guys know about blend modes? You might have found them in Filmora 9 or any other photo editing software and wondered, what are they for? If you've ever tried applying them, the results might have looked extreme or kind of weird. You want to know how these blend modes can actually be creative and practical? Hey everyone, it's JJ from Filmora here to empower your inner video creator. If you apply a layer or an image in Filmora 9, you can apply a blend mode on the top layer so that you can change the way the two layers interact with each other. I'm going to show you four creative ways on how to use blend modes and explain why they work. If you have a black piece of text or a black logo on a white background, you can spice it up by using blend modes. First, you need to find a video you want to fill the text with or use as a background. You can use an actual video footage or find an exciting background pattern like I'm using in this example. Drag your text into video track 2 and your video into video track 3. Then double-click on your footage to open up the image menu and look under the compositing menu to find the blend modes. The two blend modes we're going to focus on are linear dodge and multiply. They're usually thought of as opposites because one removes black pixels from the layer it's applied to and the other removes the white pixels. If we apply linear dodge to the video footage, you'll see how the black pixels of the text vanish and are replaced by the video underneath. Now I have a more visually interesting piece of text. This is a great effect to use on a logo or a YouTube intro. The same goes for multiply. If I apply multiply, you'll see how the black pixels of the text are unchanged, but the white pixels of the background vanish. Overexposure is when you have too much white in a clip or image. You can fix this using color correction, or if you want a quicker fix, you can use the multiply blend mode. This is the same blend mode we used in the previous trick that removes white pixels from a layer. Drag your overexposed image or footage into your timeline twice, once into the video track 1 and once into the video track 2. Make sure it's lined up to overlap itself perfectly, and then double-click on the clip in track 2 to return to the compositing menu. Apply the multiply blend mode and the overexposure of your final image is instantly reduced. In this trick, we're going to change this overcast sky to a starry night sky using the blend mode Darken. When you apply Darken to a clip, it analyzes each overlapping layer and keeps whichever is the darkest. So if you layer an image on top of a white background and apply Darken, nothing would happen. If you layer an image on top of a black background and apply Darken, your image would disappear. That's why you can use Darken to substitute a darker sky. This works best if any object like trees or people against the sky are darker than the new sky that you want to add. Otherwise, they'll disappear too. Here I've got this video of palm trees against an overcast stormy sky, and I want to change that to this starry sky. I've already got them in the timeline, so I just chose Darken from the drop-down menu, and there you go. If you're using a clip where you only want Darken to affect the sky part of your image and not some of the things under the sky, you can combine the Darken blend mode with an image mask. Go to sample colors and add the white background to the first video track. Apply Darken to your main footage, then after you save, go to the Effects tab and find the Image Mask in the Utility folder. Apply it to your new sky, then double-click on the new sky so you can edit the effect you just added. Choose the mask where you want the portion of the bottom of your clip to cut off, and then play with the Y slider to get it to the height you want. If you're trying to sync two identical clips, sometimes it's tricky to see if you've got them exactly right. The blend mode difference can help with that. Double-click on your top layer and apply difference. If you've lined up two identical frames, the screen will turn black. If you're seeing dashes of white or color, those represent areas where the two images are different. Keep working on lining the clips until you see black, and then turn off the blend mode by unchecking the box next to the compositing. And there you have it, four creative ways to use blend modes without making your image look strange. But sometimes maybe you want to embrace the strange. For example, if you're making a music video or a horror montage, sometimes layering blend modes together can give you an awesome creative look. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you guys next time.